Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I got a request from a lot of subscribers asking me to create a video on the accounting entries. So this is my first video on the accounting entries from the B2B cycle. In my next video, I'll try to cover the accounting entries for the O2C cycle, and then I'll try to cover the accounting entries for the fixed assets. So I'll not be getting into the environment, but I'll show in the spreadsheet what are the different accounting entries which are created by the system in the P2P cycle. So typically the P2P flow starts from the purchase requisition. A requester creates a purchase requisition, and once the purchase requisition is approved, the buyer converts the approved purchase requisition into a standard purchase order, and the warehouse team receives and performs the put away or the delivery. And then AP team records the invoice received from the vendor, and then AP team makes the payment, and the cash management team performs the payment reconciliation. So this is the high level flow of the P2P cycle. Now we will see the accounting entries at each of those stages. So the first thing is, I just taken a different scenario. So first scenario is like when you try to create a purchase order with inventory item. So when I say with inventory items, it's a inventory item which is not a expense item. So when you are creating a purchase requisition, there is no accounting entry. System doesn't create any accounting entry, and even during the purchase order creation, system doesn't create any accounting entry. But when you do a PO receiving, that's where the first accounting entry will be created. The receiving account for the inventory will be debited, and AP accrual account will be credited. And as far as the source is concerned, receiving account for inventory is picked up from the receiving options, whereas AP accrual account is picked up from the purchasing options. And when you perform the PO delivery or the put away, the general entry will be the inventory material value account will be debited, and the purchase price variance account will be debited or credited depending on the scenario. And then the receiving account for the inventory will be credited. So basically the inventory material value, which is debited in the scenario with a value, and that value depends on whether you are using the standard costing method or the weighted average costing. If you are using a standard costing method, then that inventory material value will be debited with the standard cost. But if you are using the average costing method, then that inventory material value will be debited with the weighted average cost of the item. And then the purchase price variance, it's a difference between the PO price and the standard cost price or the weighted average cost, depending on the costing method, whatever is being selected in your client. And the receiving account for the inventory, this is basically at the PO price. So the source for the receiving account for the inventory is, I think when you create your PO receipt, it picks up from the receiving option. When you perform the PO delivery or put away, it just picks up that particular receiving account for inventory from the concerned PO receipt. And then the AP invoice, when you create your AP invoice, AP accrual account will be debited and AP liability account will be credited. So AP accrual account is actually when you're creating the PO receipt, AP accrual account is picked up from your purchase options. And when you create your AP invoice against that particular purchase order, so it just picks up the accrual account from the PO receipt. And then when you make a payment, assuming that you are using a cash management reconciliation process, then AP liability account will be debited. So in this case, AP liability account will be picked up from your AP invoice. And when you're creating an AP invoice, AP liability account is picked up from your vendor side setup. And so when you're making an AP payment, AP liability account is debited, and cash clearing account is credited. Cash clearing account is picked up from your bank account setup. And when you make a reconciliation via cash management, then your cash clearing account will be debited and your cash or bank account will be credited. Again, the cash clearing account and the cash or bank account is picked up from your bank account setup. If you are not using the cash management reconciliation process, then the general entry will be your AP liability will be debited and your cash or bank account will be credited. So these are the accounting entries if you go with the scenario of PO creation with the inventory item. If you try to create a PO with an expense item, so which is not a inventory item, then again at the time of PO purchase requisition or PO creation, there is no accounting entry. Even for the receiving and the delivery also, there is no accounting entry, because generally you do not do any receiving or delivery for the expense item. And when you create your AP invoice, then your charge account will be debited and your AP liability account will be created. So when I say charge account, it's a charge account which is used in your purchase order. So in general, the charge account is derived in your purchase order based on your PO auto account generator. So depending on the business scenarios, most of the clients actually customize your PO auto account generator. So based on the PO auto account generated, a charge account will be derived or generated in the PO. And when you try to create your AP invoice against that particular expense PO, then the charge account which is used in your PO will be debited and your AP liability account will be created. Again, AP liability account is actually picked up from the vendor site. And then again, as far as the payment is concerned, your AP liability will be debited and your cash clearing account will be credited. Again, AP liability is picked up from your AP invoice and cash clearing is picked up from your bank account setup. So when you make a payment reconciliation via cash management, cash clearing is debited and cash or bank account is credited. The third scenario is non-PO based invoices. So the first scenario was the inventory item, second scenario was the expense item, and third scenario is just a AP invoice without any PO, just a non-PO based invoices. So it's a straightforward AP expense account is debited and your AP liability account is credited. So the source is AP expense account is basically entered by the user in your AP invoice distributions, and AP liability account, the source is the vendor site setup. And if you look into the accounting entries for different AP invoices, so as far as the standard invoice is concerned, AP expense account is debit and AP liability account is credit. So we've already seen in the above scenarios, AP expense account is debited based on whatever the user has entered in the AP invoice distributions. And of course, if it's a PO based AP invoice, the expense account or the charge account is actually derived from your purchase order, and AP liability account is derived from your vendor set. And the second type of the invoice is your credit memo, or it could be a debit memo. So for the credit memo or debit memo, the general entry is exactly opposite of that your standard invoice. So in this case, your AP liability account will be debited and your AP expense account is credited. So as far as the liability account is concerned, again, it's picked up from your vendor site, and AP expense account is concerned. Generally, whenever you create your credit memo or debit memo, you create that credit memo or debit memo against a invoice. So hence system picks up that AP expense account from the corresponding original invoice to which it is matched. But if you try to create your credit memo or debit memo as a standalone that is not against any particular invoice, then it is your responsibility to enter a proper AP expense account. And the third one is the AP prepayment. Whenever you create your AP prepayment, which is your prepayment is nothing but your advance invoices, then your prepayment account is debited and your AP liability account is created. So again, prepayment account and AP liability account, both are being picked up from your vendor site setup. So generally, when you create your AP prepayment, that prepayment can be adjusted against an invoice only once you make the payment of the prepayment. So hence, when you're making the payment of your AP prepayment invoice, your general entry will be your AP liability account is debited and your bank account is credited. AP liability account is derived from your vendor's side setup and your bank account is derived from the bank account setup. And when you apply this prepayment to your standard invoice, AP liability account is debited and your prepayment account is created. So in this case, this AP liability account is the liability account of the original invoice against which this particular prepayment is being applied. And the last one is about withholding tax. Whenever you create your AP invoice with the withholding tax codes, then your the first entry would be your AP expense account is debited and your AP liability account is credited. The entire amount of the invoice, and then your AP liability account is debited and your withholding tax payable account is credited for the withholding tax amount. Again, the withholding tax account is being picked up from your withholding tax code setup. And for the, as far as the withholding tax invoice in the name of the tax authority is concerned, whatever the withholding tax payable account, whatever is being derived here from the withholding tax code setup, that will be debited and your AP liability account is credited. So this is how, so your withholding tax payable account gets nullified because you are creating a withholding tax payable invoice in the name of the tax authority. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on Oracle Financial, please do subscribe to my channel and do not forget to refer my next video, which will be covering the accounting entries on the O2C cycle. Thank you.